Hello students, this class is for class 8 and today we are going to start from atomic structure. So this is your revisional video and we are starting from the structure of an atom, that is the Dalton's atomic theory. You know that the first idea of Paramanu was given by Maharshi Kanal, but the scientific theory and the postulates of the structure of an atom was first given by John Dalton. Okay, so we are starting from this theory. The theory given by John Dalton. So Dalton's atomic theory. The first postulate of Dalton's atomic theory is matter consists of very small indivisible particles. Okay, matter consists of very small indivisible particles, and that particles are actually an atom. So how Dalton described atom, that is every matter consists of some small indivisible particles. So matter consists of small indivisible particles, the first postulates of Dalton's atomic theory. Second is the atom can neither be created nor be destroyed. Atom can neither be created nor be destroyed. The second postulates of Dalton's atomic theory: we cannot create any atom or we cannot destroy any atom. Okay, the second postulate. Third is the atoms of an element are identical in all respect. Later we will found that some of the postulates, actually the many postulates of Dalton's atomic theory, are wrong. So we will discuss it later. So the third postulate is the atoms of an element are identical in all respects. Atoms of an element are identical. Okay. So actually these postulates is not true, we will discuss it later. The fourth is atoms of an element combine in small numbers to form molecules, and they combine in a whole number ratio. Just like water, suppose I am determining the molecule of water, it is a matter. So here hydrogen and oxygen has combined in a ratio, hydrogen is 2 and oxygen is 1. Like this. Okay, this is a small whole number. This is a small whole number. So we can say that atoms of an element combine in a simple ratio to form molecules or compounds. So atoms of element combine in simple whole number ratio. Combine in simple whole number ratio, just like 2:1 whole number ratio, to form molecules or compounds. Molecules are compounds. So if I say any molecule like oxygen molecule O2. So in oxygen molecule, see, there is two oxygen atoms, O and O, and they have combined into in 1:1 ratio, and by combining these two oxygen molecule, they are two oxygen atom, they are forming the oxygen molecule. Okay, so two atoms combining to form the molecule, And if I say about compound, just like water, here hydrogen atom and oxygen atom combining 2:1 ratio. So just like this. This is number 4. And the last point we can say that atoms can take part in any chemical reaction. They are the smallest unit. The first point was they are the smallest unit and they can take part in any chemical reaction. So number 5 we can say atoms can take part in a chemical reaction. Only the number 5, this postulates is correct in Dalton's atomic theory. The rest of the postulates are wrong and it was proven later. Okay. Between all these postulates, this postulate is correct and other is wrong, and there are some drawbacks of Dalton's atomic theory. So we are coming to that point. So next, when we are trying to come to the drawbacks of Dalton's atomic theory, we are first discovering the electron. So first is, what is an element? How can you define an element? So an element is a pure compound that cannot be decomposed into other simpler substances. Okay. So in one line we can say it is a pure substance. It is a pure substance that cannot be decomposed. Decomposed means we cannot break it into other simpler substances. So that cannot be decomposed into other simpler substances. So that is an element. So we cannot break an element. So for example, what can we give for an example of element? For example, carbon is an element, carbon, and we cannot break carbon into other element. If it is element, that means it is fixed in this form. Carbon is an element. So carbon. So next, what will be the definition of an atom? After the element, we are going to the definition of an atom. Atom. So, an atom is the smallest particle within a matter that exhibits all the properties of that matter. Actually, it is the there are 2 points. That is, it is the smallest part of the atom, any matter, and it exhibits all the properties of that matter. So we are writing 2 points. It is the smallest particle of an element. It is the smallest particle of an element. That exhibits all the properties of that element. That means if I say carbon is an element, so one atom of carbon exhibits all the properties of carbon. Carbon has some of its properties, and its all properties are maintained by one carbon atom. Each carbon atom can maintain all the properties of carbon element. So next, we are going to the discovery of the constituents of atom. Dalton, Morse, Conard has given the idea of Parmanu. Dalton has given the idea of atom, that is, it is the smallest indivisible particle. Actually, atom is the smallest indivisible particle. Next, we are coming to the point of the constituents of atom. Constituents of atom. So atom consists of three constituents, that is proton, neutron and electron, and they were invented by different scientists. So the first electron was invented by J.J. Thomson by discharge tube experiment. And what was that experiment? In a discharge tube experiment like this, say this is a discharge tube. Two metal plates are taken here. Here is one metal plate and here is another metal plate. And these metal plates are connected with an external source of electricity. Okay, so this is induction coil. Induction coil. These two are metal plates and this is vacuum pump. Okay, induction coil means it is giving the electricity. Okay, it is giving the electricity. So now when these two metal plates are connected to an induction coil, it is seen that some rays are going to this orientation. And the question is, what are these rays? Some rays are going from this portion to this portion when these two metal plates are connected to an induction coil. And the question is, what is that ray? And these rays are found that it will be the, you know, this is positively charged plate and this is negatively charged plate. For battery, you know, there is one positive charge orientation and one is negative charge. One portion is positive charge and one portion is negatively charged. So if it is connected to a battery or an induction coil, then this portion is negatively charged and this portion is positively charged, and it is found that rays are coming from negatively charged plate to the positively charged plate. That means they are going to the positively charged plate, means these rays are definitely negative. If they are negative, that means they are attracted towards the positively charged plate. So if they are going to the positively charged plate, this proves that these rays are negatively charged. So these rays are negatively charged, we can write negatively charged. Now you know that negative charge plate is known as cathode and positive charge plate is known as anode. So if this plate that is connected to the induction coil is negative and this is cathode, this plate is cathode and this plate is anode. So you can say that these rays are generating from the cathode plate. These rays are generating from cathode, and hence we can say this negatively charged rays are cathode rays. As they are generating from cathode, so these negatively charged rays are cathode rays. So in this way, by this is discharge tube experiment by J.J. Thomson. Discharge tube experiment. Discharge tube experiment, and this experiment was done by the scientist J.J. Thomson. Okay, so by this experiment, Thomson found some negatively charged particles or rays, and these are known as cathode rays. So by the invention of these cathode rays, he actually found that they are actually electrons and they are negatively charged. So this is the inventory experiment by J.J. Thomson. So today we have discussed up to the point of discovery of electrons. In the next class, we will discuss about, we will start from the discovery of protons. Okay.